When you get a good night's sleep, you feel refreshed and ready for the day. But sometimes kids have problems with sleep, and doctors need to figure out why. A sleep study can show what is or isn't causing a sleep problem. It doesn't hurt. In fact, you'll probably sleep right through it. While you're sleeping, people called sleep technicians or techs watch how your body works. They'll use computers and monitors to check on your breathing, your heartbeat, how much you move around, and even how your brain is working. So how does a sleep study work? First, you'll go to a place called a sleep center in the evening. It's kind of like going to a hotel, and you check in. A sleep tech will get you settled in your room. You can bring comfy pajamas and your favorite pillow or blanket if you want. If you need anything else to help you feel more comfortable, just ask. Everyone wants you to feel right at home, and your mom or dad will stay in the room with you all night too. Now it's time to attach the monitors that measure all that important stuff while you're asleep. This is done by using leads. A lead is a circle-shaped sticker with a wire in it. The wire goes back to the monitors. Then you'll get two belts. One goes on your chest and one on your belly to measure your breathing.
How is that? Is that good?
The leads that go in your hair use a little paste to help them stay put. Everything comes out easily in the shower the next day. A small microphone might be taped to your neck to record any snoring. The leads are usually put on your legs, arms, chest, and head. Last, a small clear tube called a nasal cannula will be placed across your nose. This helps measure your breathing. Your sleep tech will probably wrap a bandage around your head to hold the wires in place while you sleep. It can take a while to put all the leads on, so try to be patient and tell the sleep tech if you need a break. You might think you look pretty funny all wired up, but every lead has an important job to do. You'll get a small light wrapped around your finger or toe. This device keeps track of the amount of oxygen in your blood. Once everything is all set, it's lights out and time to sleep. If you want a nightlight, just ask. It may be strange to go to sleep with so many wires attached, but you'll get used to them pretty fast. You can sleep in whatever position is most comfortable for you. And if you have to go to the bathroom during the night, or your wires get a little tangled, it's no problem. Your sleep tech will be listening to you, and your mom or dad can call for help anytime. When you wake up, all the leads and wires will be taken off. This only takes about 10 minutes. Soon enough, the doctor will have your sleep results and tell you the things you can do to sleep better. Sweet dreams.